I've been trading for more than 14 years, and in those 14 years, I've read dozens and dozens of trading books. And I actually looked at my YouTube channel and I saw that I never made a video about my favorite books. And I thought it is time to do that now. And I've put together a list of 15 books that will make you a better trader and also a better person. And this list of books is going to be very different than the typical recommended reading list for traders. And I've put together a lot of books that are either unknown or not as popular, or may at the first glance not have anything to do with trading, but are super interesting, very, very helpful. So let's get into this. All the links to all the books you will find also in the video description below. And here I always put the title in white, subtitle, and then the author is in brackets. So you can look it up for yourself. And the first one is a classic one. It's one of the first ones that I've read, Come Into My Trading Room from Alexander Elder. And it is a very important book, and I think a staple book that every trader has to read at least once, probably multiple times during their trading journey, because every time you pick it up, depending on where you are in your trading right now, you're gonna draw different lessons from it. And there are so many important things that this book will teach you and will just help you to look at in a different way. And as I said, if you haven't read it in a while, make sure to pick it up again, because I'm 100% sure that when you read it now, if you haven't read it in a while, you will find very new lessons and things that didn't click before. And I also always put a few quotes from the books that I find interesting. So from Alexander Ender, I really like this one here. Amateurs look for challenges, professionals look for easy trades. Losers get high from the action, the pros look for the best odds. Really nice quotes. Second book, Pitbull. I think this is my absolute favorite trading book. It's from Marty Schwartz, who was also featured in the Market Wizards. And this book is so interesting because it has a lot of practical tips actually in it. So Marty Schwartz explains how he approaches his trades, how he approaches his charts. He even shares some actual trading strategies and tools that he uses. And one of the things that I've gotten out from it is his checklist approach. So he has been trading at that point, I guess, for decades when he wrote it. And he was one of the most successful traders. And he said in his book that he, every time he takes a trade, he reviews his checklist. It's handwritten sheet, laminated in plastic and taped to the right-hand corner of my desk. And every time he's about to take a trade, he's gonna check off the checklist, and it's gonna help you improve the quality of your trading, because you'll see right away, is this a trade that you should be taking? Yes or no. Trading in the Zone, Mark Douglas, is another one. Just like Come Into My Trading Room is just one of those that you need to read. And I like the five fundamental truths from Mark Douglas. Anything can happen. You don't need to know what is going to happen next in order to make money. There's a random distribution between wins and losses for any given set of variables. An edge is nothing more than an indication of a higher probability of one thing happening over another. Every moment in the market is unique. Very, very fascinating book. And just like Come Into My Trading Room, it really matters when you read the book, at what stage you read it. And I would always encourage you to reread those books every few months, because you will learn so much. Of course, I need to put a shameless plug to my trading book here as well. So people always ask me, what is the best technical trading book? And obviously, I have to recommend our book, and it has been an Amazon bestseller for months and months and months. The link is to that in the video description as well. So now we're going to get a little bit more into books that at first glance you have nothing to do with trading. Those are also the books that you will not find on any recommended reading list. So I'm really excited to share those books with you, because those books have a huge potential. And the first one is one of the most exciting and interesting authors and people that I've ever found, Josh Waitzkin. He has also made three or four podcasts with Tim Ferriss. He used to be a chess world champion when he was very small. He is now, as far as I know, also coaching hedge fund traders, and his book is The Art of Learning. And in this book, there are so many practical tips that are immediately and directly applicable to trading. For example, his technique, mental flushing. So what he said during chess tournaments or chess games, maybe you make a mistake and you feel aroused and emotional, but you need to get this out of your system, because it will help you look at the board with more clarity. So what he would recommend is, You go out of the room, you maybe find a flight of stairs, you run it up two or three times, or you just run around the building and you just get your head off the problem and you get those emotions out. And in trading, it's the same. How often do you feel very emotional when you made a mistake, when you lost a big trade? And the worst thing you can do is just keep trading because there are all those emotions. You cannot be objective anymore. But removing yourself from the source, removing yourself from your charts, getting your blood pumping, getting your head off of it, when you come back, the world will look very different and you can make probably much better trading decisions. Against the Gods, it's a weird title because actually the book from Bernstein is about risk and the story of risk, and there are so many nice things about risk, risk management, probability, a probabilistic mindset, and I really like this book. The commanding general is well aware that the forecasts are no good, however, he needs them for planning purposes. Or another quote, life is a collection of similarities rather than identities. No single observation is a perfect example of generality. So this book goes very deep into risk, and as traders, our job first and foremost is managing risk. So this is a book that is really, really applicable and I highly recommend it. Gambling Wizards. So very similar to the title Market Wizards, and of course I do recommend the whole Market Wizards book series, also the Hedge Fund Wizards, really, really great read, and I find it very inspirational and motivational, but I didn't want to include it, and I want to give this a shout out here, because this is often overlooked. It doesn't have a lot of reviews on Amazon, and if you like the Market Wizards book series, you're gonna love the Gambling Wizards, and you will find horse gamblers, you will find poker players, and backgammon players and many, many other gambling professionals in this book. And you will often see that they all share a very similar approach and mindset, and you can draw some interesting lessons from those books. The Subtle Art of Not Giving a F*** by Mark Manson. This has been, I think, on the bestseller list for years, ever since it came out. It's a really, really great book. So obviously you probably have heard about it. If you have not read it, I really highly recommend it. There are so many great quotes. Also, Mark Manson has a free blog on his website, which has absolutely fascinating blog articles. I can't recommend this enough. It gives you a lot of food for thought. You will look at life and specific aspects of life very differently. So I really highly recommend this book. Rich Dad, Poor Dad from Robert Kiyosaki. Obviously, as traders, we need to know about the money mindset, the wealth mindset, and Rich Dad Poor Dad is a very good introduction into all of that, just how you manage yourself, your mindset, your wealth a little bit better, what are good habits, what are things that you need to do. And as traders, if you make money, you need to also know how to keep money, who make sure that the money you made is working for you in good ways. So this is absolutely a must as well. The One Thing from Keller is a really interesting, intriguing book. I read it many, many years ago. I picked it up recently again, and it's one of those books that you just have so many aha moments when you read it. I like this quote. It's not from Keller, but he quoted it in his book. People do not decide their futures, they decide their habits, and their habits decide their futures. Also, another very interesting one is he talks about multitasking, and he explains how multitasking is a lie, and not only a lie, it is also gonna make your results worse. So really, really interesting read here, I recommend for traders. Next one, Shoe Dog. This is a biography of Phil Knight, who is the creator of Nike, and I picked this up at the book randomly, I don't even know why, and I didn't expect much from the book, but this has easily become my absolute favorite biography, and the story of how young Phil Knight went into the world, traveled the world when he was very young, started his import shoe business that then eventually became Nike, and the challenges he faced, the lessons that he learned, is just absolutely fascinating. I recommend this as an audiobook because the story and the storytelling in this book is absolutely fascinating. Another biography I really recommend is from Andre Agassi, who used to be one of the best tennis players of all time. And his book is called Open, or his biography. And I think this is very, very applicable to trading because tennis and trading share surprisingly a lot of similarities. Traders, just like tennis players, are always by themselves. They make decisions, they perform by themselves. Tennis, obviously, you are alone on your side of the net. Traders are in front of their screens all day alone. So the mental aspect of tennis is very, very similar to trading. So there are a lot of interesting things that you can draw from it. Other biographies, if you're interested in biographies, I really recommend the one from Arnold Schwarzenegger. It's surprisingly motivating. It's a really fascinating read to see how he came up from the middle. He grew up in the middle of nowhere, somewhere deep in the mountains of Austria, made his way to America. He actually became a millionaire well before he was famous as a bodybuilder. And his mindset, his work ethic and attitude is just fascinating. If you have not read the book from David Goggins, also highly recommended. It's super motivational, really great book as well. Next one. So now we're getting a little bit more spiritual with my last picks, and those books will not make sense for everyone, and you need to be at the right moment in your life to really click and resonate with those books. But this one, it really changed everything for me, and this was a huge pivot in my life. The Untethered Soul, Michael Singer in general. He has two or three books which I read many times each one, and I read them at different stages in my life, and they really changed how I approach my view of life as well, and everything really about it. And a big part of what he talks is about the voice in our head and how the voice can be good, how it's often used or how it can be detrimental as well, how we manage it, what should be our relationship to the voice in our head. And this is a fascinating book. New Earth from Eckhart Tolle. I think what I did in the beginning, as I read The New Earth and The Untethered Soul, for 6 months, I read The New Earth, then I went back to The Untethered Soul and back and forth until I read each one, I think like 5 times, and they really fit together nicely. However, you need to be in the right frame of mind and the right position in your life. Otherwise, they will just sound weird and not make sense. But if you are into spiritual reading and you are interested in exploring the voice in our head and what does it do, where does it come from, how do we manage it, and a lot of pitfalls, then I cannot recommend those two books enough. The Monk Who Sold His Ferrari was the first book that I ever picked up as a spiritual book. It's not super spiritual, but it's a very nice introduction. I read it, I think, the first time when I was just 18 probably, and it has completely changed the trajectory of my life. Everything since I've read this book has changed in my life. And if you are, or if you know somebody who may be a little bit interested in spirituality, but you don't want to overwhelm him with a book like The New Earth and Untethered Soul, this is a very, very good introduction. The Monk Who Sold His Ferrari is a very epic read. There are lots of practical tips, which makes sense, and you don't need to be deep involved into it. It's also no spiritual mumbo jumbo. It's really, really practical. I like the book a lot. Another book which did make it onto my list, I don't even know why, The Alchemist by Paulo Coelho. It's the first book I think that I ever read outside of school. This was my first book that I've ever read voluntarily on my own. And I think at this point I've probably read it more than 20 times easily. And this is the book that really set me off on my journey to explore the world, to live on my own, to just look for amazing things outside of my comfort zone and to really throw myself out there. So The Alchemist, Paulo Coelho, also highly recommended. So that's it. I could go on for hours and hours probably about book recommendations. If you find this interesting and you want me to share maybe a part two of other books that I have read that I think will help traders or anyone in that matter, make sure to leave a comment, give this video a big fat thumbs up. All the links to all the books are in the video description. There are no affiliate links, so there's no bias behind it. So just make sure that you pick them up, read them, load up in your reading library, and have fun with them.